too good in strike. No edge damage. Nothing loose. Holding up well.
Here's the tip after stabbing it to a vehicle's wood. Holding up very well. Straight, solid, nothing loose. Moving on.
Check out the tip.
Looking good. Here are the marks. Penetration marks still dripping. Holding up well. The edge here. Still good and straight. Let's look here at the impact marks. Come over here around this side. Let's see here. Here's the fresh impact marks. Holding up well. So far, so good. See the edge differences here. Took some minor scuffs on the Daywalker 2, but no damage, no serious damage. You can see the differences between the two. Blade's still good and straight. Held up well. Doesn't look like there's any edge damage. Still good and straight. All right, check out the pole here versus the edge. Going well so far.
Thing feels tight. Let's look at the edge here.
Took a little edge damage, of course. Striking any sword against something that solid is going to damage the edge. It doesn't matter what it's made of. But it held up well. Didn't break. That was my main concern, to make sure it's safe for people to buy. So I'm impressed. Daywalker 2 is held up. I will give my final thoughts. Thank you guys.
Jason Woodard here with my final thoughts on my newest sword design. This is the Daywalker 2 design. This is the second one I've designed. I've made some changes. I've made the blade a little bit wider, a little bit shorter for strength. Has a wider guard to protect the hand. Has a wider pommel to keep the hand from sliding down so easily. It's now wrapped in black deerskin leather for more of a secure grip and absorbs more shock. This has held up very well to all of my harsh testing. Feels good in the hand, it performs well. It bounces just about three and a half inches past the guard, so it's got a great balance point. It feels good, easy to use. It's held up well to all of my testing, striking, jugs. The edge is held up, it's very sharp. Wood, metal, having it through a steel drum, through a car hood, the tip is held up very well. I've struck it against granite, and that's where the most damage occurred, on the edge. I've actually ground that off, and that was not hard to do. But striking any sword against granite is going to damage it, so I advise you not to try that at home. It's held up very well. Nothing has come loose. The blade has stayed good and straight. Very proud of this design. The pre-orders are already doing very well, and the Doomsday line is killing it, so I really appreciate your guys' support. Thank you very much. You can also get the nice buffalo hide leather sheath. These are made to order by Chris Palmer as they are ordered. This is in partnership with Paul Southern at the Sword Buyer's Guide. So this has held up very well. I'm very proud of it. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll be working on my next design to be coming out here pretty soon. So thank you guys, and stay tuned.